I want to thank Squarespace for making this video possible. Go to squarespace.com/polyphonic and use the offer code polyphonic to get 10% off your first purchase. One day, death will come for us all. It's an unfortunate reality that people have spent a lot of time thinking about throughout the years. People have written countless poems, plays, and songs about mortality and having to face it. But then in 1976, one band asked a different question. What if we decided to embrace death instead of running from it? The result is one of the most infamously haunting songs of all time. It's one that's featured in classic horror movies and even quoted directly by horror legend Stephen King. Since its release, Don't Fear the Reaper has become a cultural touchstone, and it remains one of the most haunting songs in rock history. Let's take a closer look. Despite its dark use, Don't Fear the Reaper is actually a love song at its heart. Songwriter Buck Dharma explained what he was trying to get at with the song, saying, "The whole idea of the Reaper was that if there was another sphere of existence, maybe lovers could bridge that gap if their love was strong enough." The chorus of the song taps into this, singing of the freedom that can come with love, and encouraging a lover to take Dharma's hand. He adds to his point in the second verse, which name drops Valentine and also discusses Romeo and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet are together in eternity. Romeo and Juliet, 40,000 men and women every day. Honestly, looking at the song as the sum of its parts, Don't Fear the Reaper shouldn't be such a creepy song. Sure, it's in A minor, but the main riff itself isn't too dark, and the song is full of warm, lush harmonies. In fact, the most common artist the song gets compared to is The Byrds, a band that's seldom described as creepy. But at the same time, there's something different about Don't Fear the Reaper. Something that's led it to be used in horror movies in dark contexts ever since its release. In 1978, just 2 years after the song came out, director John Carpenter put Don't Fear the Reaper into his horror classic Halloween. The song plays as two teenagers share a joint, unknowingly being followed by the murderous Michael Myers. It creates a sense of dramatic irony as death itself follows the two characters.
For that matter, I might as well be a Girl Scout myself tonight. I plan on making popcorn and watching Dr. Dementia. 6 straight hours of horror movies. Little Lindsay Wallace won't know.
Rob Zombie called back to that song's use in his 2007 remake of Halloween as well. And then there's Stephen King, a master of horror. He claimed that the song was part of the inspiration for his post-apocalyptic opus, The Stand. King quotes Don't Fear the Reaper in the opening of the book, and then when the book was adapted into a miniseries in 1994, it was used for the opening title sequence, panning over shots of dead bodies. Seasons don't fear the reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain. Then of course there's its use in Supernatural, where it plays as a character called a Reaper kills a woman in the forest. It's since gone on to be emblematic of the series, synonymous with death, horror, and the supernatural. So why is this song about the power of love used in so many dark contexts? I think it's because humanity is just not that good at buying the message. We do fear the Reaper, and simply talking about death can completely recontextualize a song. But this is something that Blue Oyster Cult were aware of when they were writing. Dharma has even said that he considers the song in the horror genre. This is why they open the song on such haunting words. All our times have come. All our times have come. In some of the most beautiful lines of the song, Dharma talks about how death is a natural force. Other natural forces don't fear it. And while it's an optimistic message, it cuts both ways. By reminding us that seasons don't fear the Reaper, Dharma reminds us of the impermanence of our own life. Seasons don't fear the Reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain. Dharma sings that you can escape this impermanence with a true, pure love. But when we listen, most of us focus not on the escape, but on the reality. This is amplified at the end of the second verse, when they sing that 40,000 men and women die every day. The real number is actually far higher than that. Dharma just needed to match the right number of syllables for the song. Right now, an estimated 150,000 people die every day. It's another reminder of your own mortality, dissonantly paired by a chorus singing of flying, freedom, and love. Baby, take my hand, don't feel the reaper. We'll be able to fly. Some people read the song as encouraging suicide, especially by following up the number of deaths with the line, "We could be like they are." Dharma insists that wasn't what he was trying to get at, though. He said, "It is like not to be afraid of death, as opposed to actively bringing it about. It's basically a love song where the love transcends the actual physical existence of the partners." And though it's about transcending death, the image of death lingers ever present in the song. This is especially true 2.5 minutes in, where we get a dramatic musical shift. The riff that has driven the song drops out and we're met with silence and darkness. Then we break into an eerie instrumental passage. This is where the horror really comes in, with a wailing guitar and tense drumming. This is the Reaper personified, the shadow of death that follows all of us. Musically, this reflects the message of the song when the darkness is cut through by the brighter main riff. That smooth riff is the love that can help you cut through the darkness of death. However, even after the breakdown, one thing remains throughout the entire next verse. It's easy to miss, but there's a piece of feedback hanging in the background. The darkness still lingers there. The final chorus of the song transcends into fantasy. As the two lovers realize that they can achieve a pure, true love, they clasp hands and begin to fly. Then they turn back and wave farewell to this mortal realm as they pierce the veil, ready to explore the beyond. Don't Fear the Reaper is a song made creepy by its dissonance. It sings of love and death in shared warm harmonies, and it makes us reflect on our own mortality. And in creating such a strange, beautiful, dark song, Blue Oyster Cult have themselves escaped death in a sense. Don't Fear the Reaper is an immortal song, and so Blue Oyster Cult are immortal, and they no longer need to fear the Reaper. I want to thank Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Go to squarespace.com/polyphonic to start your free trial today, and make sure to use the offer code polyphonic to show them I sent you and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. If you're looking to make a website for anything in your life, your band, your blog, your business, Squarespace is the place for you. It's an all-in-one platform where you can use designer templates to build your own website or store. I recently used Squarespace to build a website housing all of my playlists, and honestly, it was really easy. Their interface was completely user-friendly, it was all just drag and drop, and I didn't run into any problems at all. But if you do, they've got award-winning 24/7 customer service. So head on over to squarespace.com/polyphonic to start your free trial today. Make sure to use the offer code polyphonic to show them that I sent you, and you'll save 10% off your first purchase of a website or a domain.